So, I was browsing my YouTube messages, and a girl whose name is Susan, and her YouTube username is SusanWilson13. I'll provide her link below. Christian, I'm doing this so that you will give her words of encouragement. Christians, children of God. Okay, so she wrote me a message and it said, "Hey, please pray that I receive salvation and pray that I receive the gifts of the Holy Spirit." And so she says, "Hey, do you have a testimony video?" And I said, "No." And I thought, "Why don't I have a testimony video? And I have all these gifts God has given me this summer, all these spiritual gifts." And I'm like, "Why in the world don't I have a testimony video? People want to know how I got these gifts and how it came about." So here's my testimony video, and this is dedicated to Susan Wilson 13. For you, girl. She's a 15-year-old girl, so women, especially the women, give her words of encouragement on her on a channel, do messages and stuff or whatever. Videos are awesome. Alright, for you. First, let me introduce you who I am. My name is Jasmine Thomas. God calls me Harmani Harasimi, which means peace and quiet. I'm 18 years old, and in 2010, I graduated from high school. After summer of 2011, I'm going to start my second year of college. I'm currently majoring in biochemical engineering. I have a 4.0 GPA, and later I plan on majoring in psychology. This summer, God has blessed me with a multitude of gifts like healing, casting out demons, and I speak about 8,000 tongues. And on my YouTube channel, I'll touch another video under this one telling you all the gifts which I have begotten from God. So, picture this. It's the last quarter of the year. And around your college, it feels like anxiety and depression and worry. They're all the same, right? And so, me, I'm like laid back. So, I'm like, I'm getting all A's. I got this. And so, I don't get it. Why are people depressed? Like, just study and you'll be all right for the finals. It's not like if you don't pass the final, you're gonna lose your life. So I study and stuff. Oh, then guess what happens? 3 weeks before summer, 2 weeks before my finals, I break my computer. Okay, I didn't break it. Okay, I just ruined the screen, but I couldn't use it because I couldn't see anything on the screen. Oh, and I couldn't use my sister's because she's in college too and she needs her computer to study. Oh, and guess what? About 9% of my schoolwork is online. So you see how that messed me up there. So what did I do? I had to wake up at about 7 or 8, walk to college, come back, pick up my brothers, drop them off a huge hill at my house, or drop them off to my uncle's house if he's there. And then I had to go back to school and do my classes. And after that, because I had night classes, come back. I usually cleaned or I did my homework or I wrote an essay. Okay, that puts a D in depression. So after a while, I started doing that. So I continued to do that schedule for a while, and I became getting depressed because I didn't have time to get like some of my schoolwork done, and I wanted all A's, and I just feel like I was alone. I ended up not eating for 2 days. On top of it off, my mom was mad at me, so I just felt totally alone, and I stopped praying altogether. I knew I should trust in God, but that's a different story, let me tell you. Okay, so like before all this happened, let me tell you about my relationship with God. I was head over heels for Him. Okay, let me tell you how. See, I've been listening to two pastors. One's name is Paul Washer and J.K. Lewis, and they're like the only two pastors that preach the true word of God, you know, because I'm not into all these pastors on television all wanting money and stuff. So, you know, I only listen to those two pastors. And so I did all I can to try to please God. You know, I tried to obey His law. I'm saved, but so I tried to obey His law. I took every evil thing. I don't watch secular television, listen to secular music, cuss. I don't do all these things. So I put my whole life in position with God's will for my life, because I know He has a will, right? So I positioned my life in that way, right? And so I did that, I think, for like 2 years or a year and a half. And so I'm wondering, why in the world is God talking to me? Because, you know, I'm praying, I'm fasting, I'm doing these fasts for like 30 days, and I'm fasting for like one day, fasting, don't fast for a day, and fasting again. Like, I'm doing that, right? I'm doing all I can to you. My heart is just for Him, right? And I'm thinking, why in the world does He talk to me, you know, by now? You know, because I've been praying since forever, waiting. It's been years, 2 years, a year, and I've been like, why in the world hasn't He been talking to me? And so, wow, you know? And so this situation comes up at school where I break my computer, I have depression, anxiety. And during the whole time, I did not pray, because I completely gave up. I thought in my head, you know what? Maybe God isn't talking to me because He only talks to His special children, His special dogs, you know, the pastors and the, you know, all those people, just the special people. So also, you know, I just started feeling hurt, you know, to the point where I can't even think about Him, because I'm like, oh my gosh, I love Him so much, and it's like, He doesn't even love me back. Stupid thought, right? But I thought that, like, you talk to all these people, but not me? Wow. So it was like, I did everything on the missionaries, evangelists, pastor, session, do pray, repent, and everything. And God still hasn't spoke to me or anything, so I'm just like, I don't know. So I continued the procedure, going to school, picking up my brothers, all that stuff. And top it off, my mom was mad at me. So, but later on, I just kept doing what I did. And so I ended up taking my finals and passing my classes. And so it was all good. But I was still depressed because I was sad. And, you know, my mom was mad and that I broke my computer, because I'm a person who loves technology. So, you know, my computer broke. I'm like, oh my God. So during this time, I was like chilling. And so, you know, it was summer for me. And so I was in my room, and it was nighttime, about 10 o'clock, and all the lights were off in my room. So it was completely dark, and I was walking back and forth in my room thinking. And mom came and knocked on my door and said, actually, she opened it. She said, what are you doing? I'm just thinking. She says, okay, God wants me to pray for you. And so I said, okay. And so she prayed for me. And so every time my mom would pray for me, my body would start jerking. Like this, and then after someone stopped praying for me, my body would stop jerking. But that's only usually after someone would pray for me, I would stop jerking. But this time I didn't. I kept jerking and kept jerking. But this time my mom was already downstairs in her room, so I went downstairs to her room and I said, I keep jerking, and it won't stop. And so she said, oh, just praise God. And so I praised God. And after a while, after my mom prayed for me and we praised God, I started speaking in tongues. And so I was like, wow, it was really an exciting experience. And then after, me and my mom talked, and then I went back upstairs to go to sleep, and I noticed while I was sleeping, kept jerking all through the next morning, too. And the next morning, I went downstairs to my mom's room. I said, I'm still jerking. I don't know what's going on. And my mom says, I've never seen the Spirit of God upon someone that long before. And she thought, you know, it wasn't the Spirit of God. She thought it was the devil messing with me, or she thought I was hyperventilating, because as I was jerking, I was also breathing in like this, like that. So she had paper bags over my face and plastic bags, you know, and then she's like, oh, you know, I need to take you to the hospital. And so I went to the hospital, me, my sister, Joycelyn, and the doctors ran tests. They couldn't find nothing wrong. And so me and my mom were just in this hospital room, and we just began talking. I really believe God made me jerk that long for this moment that me and my mom be in the hospital room to talk, because remember, she was mad at me and stuff, and I was depressed, so we talked, and after we talked, I wasn't really depressed anymore, because I feel better. And so God told my mom that she'll be okay at 1 o'clock, and I was okay at 1 o'clock. I stopped jerking. So, you know, after I stopped jerking, me and my mom went home, and every day for about 2 weeks, I was on my knees praising God, and then I started speaking in tongues, and I kept praising Him, and then all of a sudden, one day, I found out I could speak in tongues willfully and stop willfully when I want to. And so I asked God in tongues, because my mom said, when you speak in tongues, you speak directly to God. So I'm like, really? So when I spoke in tongues, I asked God, what am I saying, or what are you saying to me? He says, daughter, I am telling you that you will preach to millions of millions and thousands of thousands of people. Now, he spoke that through me, and, you know, I went crazy. I was just like, wow, you know? And I continued to speak tongues, and I found out later, after I kept speaking in tongues, I mean, I spoke in tongues all day, every day, every second, right? That I could speak to God directly. I could communicate with Him directly. Like, if I ask Him a question in my heart, in my mind, He'll answer me right back, you know? And so I thought that was so awesome because, you know, very few people have that. So I was just like, yes! And then as time went on throughout the summer, I realized that I could see in the spirit realm. I saw angels and demons, and I can also heal people too, you know, and with that brought upon other gifts. And if you really want to know the gifts that I have, then again, you should go to my YouTube channel, and under this video is another video called Gifts God Has Given Me. And I'll tell you all the gifts that I have that He gave me. He gave me all these gifts, and it just blew my mind, and it's crazy. And that's how everything came about. Like, I just praised Him. I prayed, and then He gave me all these gifts as I kept talking to Him and spending time with Him. Because you must know that I was seeking God for His gifts. I wasn't following religion. My greatest desire, my greatest desire was to be with Jesus. I just wanted to know Him. That's it. Nothing else. I just want to be close to Him. That is my greatest desire. That is what I strive for. And then He gave me all these gifts. And so I asked Him, how did He give me, why did you give me all these gifts? And He said, because I'm going to use you in a great way. And so I made myself a vessel to Him, which led to I could go to heaven and hell, and if I want to, but I usually go to heaven. Why would I want to go to hell? By God putting me in a trance, and I fellowship with Him right in front of His face. And I told Him, I said, when I was in Jesus' presence one time, I said, Jesus, I'll do anything for you. And he smiled and he said, really, do you promise? And I said, yes. And then he said, okay, he smiled and said, I'm gonna hold you to that promise. And I'm like, okay, and then I hugged him. And so that's what happened. And I'll tell you what heaven's like in a different video, but that's a whole other video. Okay, so let me just give you an update on what's going on. Since then, because this was like halfway during the summer, God has been sharpening the gifts which I already have, and talking with me and working with me for a ministry he has me to start. He's going to start and meet in a couple days. I'm not sure how, but all I know is I'm queuing my eyes up there. And I speak about 8,000 tongues. God has used me to bring my whole family to Christ. Both my sisters speak in tongues now. And my brothers are going to speak in tongues soon, and they're 11 and 7. And God has also, I guess you call me a prophetess. I don't know. I've never called myself that word, really, but other people seem to call me that. But he has given me a lot of insight on what's going to happen, like the earthquake that's going to happen on April 20th in New York, California, and Texas, and the tornado that's going to be in Missouri in about 19 days. No, you should say 18 days. And he's continuing working with me and for a ministry, because apparently he has said I'm gonna bring millions of people. He's gonna use me to bring millions of people into himself. So, you know, I'm just remaining as an open vessel to him. I just wanna, you know, that's it. Thank you for listening. Now, it's it. That's completely it. More videos coming soon.